expect an incredibly turbulent environment in this Extreme Rules match with Jinder Mahal, MVP, and R-Truth.
Extreme Rules are sort of an oxymoron. The only rule you really have here is to earn that pin or submission in the ring and respond with a counter of their own. Going counter for counter, now can it be capitalized on?
Right to the kidneys from behind.
Turns that back on Jinder.
Each superstar trying to stay a step ahead.
Downward spiral.
Uppercut connects.
Big boot. You know, I have to ask Corey, how much of an actual strategy is there in a no disqualification match?
Honestly, it depends on the superstar's mindset. Some just want to get through. Others want to inflict as much damage as possible, and some just go with the flow. Know which mindset you have before the match and stick to it.
He's going for the pin.
And the shoulder's up in time.
He ain't getting paid by the hour. Big hammer connects.
Hits him with the counter. Coming back into the ring, back to the action. Jinder manages the counter. He's taking this to the floor now.
It's in mind. Take it from me. Nothing good.
Jinder with a drop to the hold. Looking to put this one away. Camel clutch lock. He breaks up the hold.
Back elbow finds the mark.
Elbow after elbow.
Down they go. Jinder looking to intimidate his opponent. Smash. Saw that one coming. Took advantage. Okay, he's re-entering the ring. Powerless position to be in right now. Remarkable. He's got the pin. This could be it. Abdominal stretch. It's locked in.
This is a great way to wear down your opponent.
Give up now. Swallow your
abdominal stretch.
Fighting out.
That's one way to get out of it. Nice.
And will it be?
And the count's broken. Keeping the match alive.
It's not over yet. He's coming.
Arms trap. Just unloading knees to the body.
Forced out of the ring. He climbs into the ring.
Went for something, but got a stiff elbow to the head instead.
MVP's words are just as damaging as his actions.
And he has free reign to the outside with no countouts to worry about. Leaving nothing to chance here with a baseball bat in hand.
And what a good move we just saw there.
MVP fends that off.
Turns that back on Jinder. Oh my God, a clothesline.
Horseshoe calf kick.
Setting up for something here.
We'll take things into the ring.
Just like that, he sent crashing to the floor. I don't know what they're looking for here. He's one step ahead, though. And we just saw some serious offense.
Is it enough? Is it enough for Jinder?
Oh, man, landing awkwardly.
Cover here!
And he goes into the ring.
Kick to the gut. Oh, brutal form.
Right,
Here's Truth sent hard to the outside. Oh! He's reaching under the ring for anything useful. Oh, did you hear that? And MVP is brought to a disadvantage now.
A smothering offense from the Maharaja.
Moves outside. What's the plan here?
Oh, in the chest as well.
Producing a trampling. Taking this one back to the ring now.
Oh, clothesline!
He leaves the ring and there's no cutouts in this one. Shot in the face, gets it.
Jinder Mahal with a drop to the head, looking to put this one away.
Oh, camel clutch! Yes. Camel clutch!
Cinched in!
And he may have felt his grip slipping, so he releases the hold.
Still was able to produce some considerable damage though.
Dodge!
Successful bit of offense with that maneuver.
Will that stop it?
There he is. Jinder Mahal is your winner.
Here is your winner, the modern day Maharaja, Jinder Mahal.
Standard Shelton Benjamin.
And if ever a nickname was earned, it's Shelton's. He has multifaceted to the superstars you're ever gonna meet. Grappling, strikes, he can do it all. The guy's a legit 5-tool player.
Truly one of the toughest measuring sticks there is today in WWE.
And then you've got the decorated superstar, Robert Roode, known to use every vicious trick you can think of in the ring. Roode will do whatever it takes to keep himself moving forward on a path to fortune and glory.
And I applaud his unwavering ambition.
Roode has gone far in this business by always looking out for himself. You don't get the kind of global recognition Robert Roode has by playing nice. You get it by being cutthroat.
And that was taking the attack to the competition with that one.
Got the leg and drops the elbow.
Oh, no. Stop right to the gut.
His 2 decades of experience in this matchup, it could be enough to get the win. The more he utilizes all of that incredible knowledge, the more dangerous he'll be tonight.
That's smart thinking, and I'm sure Roode won't hesitate to put those veteran ring smarts to work. And here we go now, elbow drop. Shelton's getting worked on right now.
You can tell Roode's putting all of his veteran skills to work, and that makes him a dangerous competitor.
Going right after the neck.
Neck breaker connects.
Ooh.
Answering back.
What are we going to see here?
Ah, crush a hamstring.
Hey, you can't do that. Now, that was a very questionable attack. I think it goes beyond any gray area.
This match's brutality starting to show on him.
And this match is not over yet. Things are only going to get harder from here.
Attacking the foot.
Oh, that hurts.
Oh, raking the back. That's nasty.
All's fair in love and war, gentlemen. I saw nothing but effective offense.
He catches Shelton with a counter.
Catches a punch.
Benjamin answers back. He's got him scouted.
Shelton is all poise and confidence, but you gotta wonder if he should press the advantage instead.
Action needs to return to the ring and fast. And that definitely made solid impact.
Excellent ring IQ to see the refs count and return to the ring in time.
Oh, come on. Why would you stoop that low?
Oh, clothesline.
And gentlemen, Shelton Benjamin may be fading away here.
Might want to walk it off for shaking off or do whatever he needs to do to get his head in the game here.
Some of the shine is coming off the gold standard at this point.
I bet you're proud of yourself for that one, aren't you, Byron?
Actually, I am.
Well placed knees to the hamstring. And now Rude has all gears in motion. Yeah, Benjamin having trouble fighting back.
And Rude saw it coming.
Lost with a belly to belly.
It's hard to believe, but it looks like he still has some gas left in the tank.
All right,
Fails to connect on the springboard. Dropkick.
Oh, that hurt.
Oh, callous rake. You can see the marks forming already. And the hits to the core keep coming. Stomach to reverse that maneuver. Hanging back with their own count. Spinebuster! For the win! Two! I thought he had it!
You gotta be kidding me!
Incredible. Absolutely incredible.
And this just goes to show you how confident Robert Roode must feel.
Gets inside the ring. Standing dropkick.
Here he goes.
Shelton's getting worked on right now.
You're not going to find Roode showing any...
Kick to the gut. Glorious DDT.
Will Roode take advantage?
Two count. Oh, he just kicked out.
Wow, looks like this book has a couple more chapters in it.
We might be seeing a whole saga written tonight. And now the question runs in the mind, how am I going to be able to end this? We're seeing an unbelievable performance in front of us.
And how these competitors are still surviving is beyond explanation.
And he's on the ropes. The official sees that it waves off the pin.
The time is now for Shelton to shift the tides.
Evade.
Handicap matches always create a tough predicament, and in this one, it's going to be Boogeyman. Across from them, they will be dealing with MVP. It's Shelton Benjamin.
And I'm still questioning why someone would agree to this match. Maybe there's something you have to prove here. Maybe you want to test your toughness.
Yeah, but it doesn't really matter how tough you think you are. In this situation, all it takes is one blindsided attack to have you leave it here in a stretcher. Series of reversals.
And what a hit.
Reversal from MVP. Hellacious power slam.
An intense street slam.
And Boogeyman stringing together some good offense.
Now MVP has to plot a way to get back into this.
Ooh. My goodness. Fending off Boogeyman.
MVP managing to get some control back now.
MVP needed that to get himself out of jeopardy.
Chunk slam!
Planted.
The Boogeyman making sure the WWE Universe is thoroughly creeped out.
Spear! Spear!
I think it's fair to say that with any handicap match, ultimately the superstar or superstars who find themselves on the wrong side of the numbers game have to find a way to survive.
Absolutely. Fighting to survive is paramount in a handicap match by any means necessary. Boogeyman's
Took him out to me.
Look, the most intelligent competitor in a battle knows that there are many roads to victory, including the low road.
Saw it coming and slowed it down with the back elbow. What a 10th Street slam.
He has him in his grasp. Oh, what a choke slam. Tossed him across the ring.
Not the prettiest thing you'll ever see, but it sure looks effective from here.
Ooh, headbutt from the rear. Oh, fourth to the back of the neck.
Spinebuster.
99.
He's struggling a bit here.
Oh, come on, Cole. No one leaves a handicap match completely unscathed.
Great timing on that knee to the gut.
Each competitor showing they've done their homework.
Oh, he retaliates.
Northern Lights bomb.
Goodness.
Headed up, he's thinking big.
Gets the tag.
Into the corner.
An elusive Benjamin there.
Look at Shelton up top.
Oh my God.
Oh, huge miss there.
See an answer for every move attempted.
He got planned for him.
Boogeyman retaliates.
Big back body drop.
Oh, did you see that height on that?
Booty boat.
And tag.
He's in now.
Finally.
Mistake made by MVP.
What a counter.
Reciprocating the initial.
Both super.
As this match goes on, is there any self-doubt running through the minds of these competitors?
You can't even allow that notion to creep into your head. You have come too far and fought too hard to grow weak now.
And he keeps his focus on an attack to that area.
Boom! Right to the body.
Slamming their face down.
section connects.
Back with a punch to the gut.
Oh, brutal form.
And Shelton only finds himself on the defensive.
Yeah, the boogeyman really remaining the aggressor here.
Here is your winner, the Boogeyman.
And what an uphill battle it was to outlast every other superstar in this match.
Yeah, what a match. I can only imagine how they must feel right now.
Yeah, a certain amount of pride has to come with surviving elimination matches.
Before you know it, there could be bodies crashing everywhere.
Sending it up the corner.
Oh boy. My God, what a striking display.
Setting it in place here. He's turning the tables.
Stalemate of counters.
And what a number we just saw there. He's lost some of his win now.
Lands a knee.
Working his way up the ladder now.
This is a critical moment.
Oh, trying to sneak a victory here.
Shocked if this doesn't end in a crash back this time.
Me too. Looks like he's got it where he wants it.
Yeah, but this will not end well, I promise you.
He's back to the ring.
There's a combo of strikes.
Knee right to the face. Right to the back.
This is right for him. Kick with precision.
Injury with that one.
Samoan drop.
Oh, a kick. Wow, jeez. He may be in a bad way here.
Ladder matches are all about high risk for high reward, but right now the pain might not be feeling worth the cost.
Kick right to the gut.
Hoisted up on their shoulders.
And we just saw some serious offense. Yeah. He's setting it up on the ring apron right now.
You've got to wonder what he has in mind here.
Whoa, not quite yet.
Just sending a message there.
Well, this is a warning to grab our stuff and go.
Keep it in the ring, please. Saxton's a very fragile boy.
Coming back in the ring. Looking for a little bit of high risk here, it seems.
Using the ladder as a weapon. Ouch.
This is not going to end well by any means.
Oh, God. Better check your teeth after that.
One step ahead of Riddle there. Riddle turns that around. He's getting it.
Knee strike connects.
Several right hands, and he's out. Being carried around with ease.
Across the throat.
Great counterattack.
impressive ring IQ on display there.
Right across the face. Apollo letting him know it's too easy. He's heading back to the ring.
Apollo Crews. Love to deliver. Multiple suplexes.
Turnbuckle.
Oh, Nakamura!
And crashing down, landslide!
Arms trapped. One after the other.
Oh, wicked kick to the lower back.
And up the ladder we go!
Climbs back inside.
Case and let someone else win it.
And as both men know, you have to wonder where they find the energy to climb the ladder again.
I think we are witnessing a career-altering moment for these superstars, guys.
The spoils will only go to the victor, and I have a feeling we're close to finding out exactly who that will be.
I don't know about you guys, but this looks like quite a gamble to take at this point in the match.
I agree with you, Corey.
And did you hear the impact of that?
You have to think Priest is feeling confident to be taunting like this.
I don't know how stable that looks, Michael.
Taking the fight near our announce table.
I really hope we get these desks at a discount.
He's staring his opponent down, getting into that zone.
And we've seen blow after blow taken up in that area. Something needs to be done.
You have to show some remorse at this point, some compassion, and end this.
Not going to win this match, setting it up there. Out on the apron.
Oh, this is going to be bad. This is going to be really bad.
Back suplex on the apron.
Bullseye with the drop kick.
Damian Priest showing no fear, no intimidation.
And Cole, that's not where you want to be at this point in the match.
Jumping neckbreaker. Ouch. There are plenty of ways battling in this area. Could end in serious
from the top.
Gets him with the counter.
Oh.
And he goes into the ring, just carrying the opposition anywhere they want. And his torso continues to be targeted.
That could be disrupting the flow of air at this point.
And that's what we call the tree of woe position, folks.
Inelegant exit, but if it works, it works.
Cut off with a kick to the gut.
He's setting up the ladder now.
Looks like to me he's got him in the right spot, Michael. Climbing the ladder.
Oh, my. Hanging on for dear life.
No ladder. Just a long fall awaiting them. Trying to find his bearings, but it looks like his end is near.
Gets inside the ring.
Attack to the midsection. Squarely on his opponent. The volume in this building has increased exponentially. The fans are willing these competitors to push forward.
Win or lose, these superstars are going to be held in high esteem after this one.
On the shoulders and a slam. That gets reversed on Apollo.
Vicious knee to the body.
Oh, axe kick. And that was a well-executed attack. Getting the ladder set now.
This could be the beginning of the end.
He gets back into the ring. And here's Cruz. He's set flying. And out of the ring he goes.
He's heading for higher ground.
This is it. He could do it right here.
Questionable timing of this move, Cole.
Ooh. Oh, my gosh.
shot.
Oh my gosh, what impact!
Uh-oh.
Clearing the table.
They're gonna take it to the next level.
What is the superstar thinking?
They're thinking about the end. Finishing this thing off by any means necessary.
I'd be shocked if this is it, Michael.
And back in the ring we go.
Just a few steps away from victory now.
And hooks it. He wins the ladder match.
Here is your winner, the original Bruno, Matt Riddle.
This is an absolutely incredible scene here. This matchup brings total annihilation and bodies everywhere.
Well, this is a dangerous situation that goes far beyond defeating your opponent.
This form of combat brings competitors irreparable harm. The goal should be just to make it out alive.
Able to reverse that one.
Is it possible to devise a game plan as a competitor when you're embarking on a journey through hell?
Competitors must resign themselves to the fact that doing battle in this torturous structure means their mind, body, and soul will never be the same again.
Out of the ring and even closer to the chain link enclosure. This is what you call high risk, high reward.
He caught him by surprise.
Oh God, that hurt.
Military press.
Yeah. Oh, a slam. The damage he's taken is starting to pile up.
No one is fully prepared for Hell in a Cell. He better brace for more.
Batista's unleashed.
The animal is in full force.
Oh, right in there.
Now Umaga looking for some momentum.
Yeah, but Umaga needs to maintain that offense now.
Go, Slender!
And here's a cover.
And a kick out by the animal.
He was really looking for a quick pinfall there.
Oh, man.
Reversal after reversal, proving they did their homework.
And come on, is that really called for?
All's fair.
Into the cover! He wasted no time kicking out there.
Shrugging off the pin like it's nothing. And after this match has already gone for so long.
Umaga is in a distressing spot.
Yeah, somehow Umaga has to turn the tide.
Kick out before a one count? It's stunning.
Batista now must be having withdrawals in his mind. Unsure where to go from here, as that move usually puts most men away. Mistake by Umaga. Batista dishing it out now.
Watch out, the animal is foaming at the mouth.
Counter from Umaga.
Yeah, but Umaga needs to maintain that offense now.
Look at the look on his opponent's face, Cole. He can't believe it.
And that was a precisely measured attack. He's getting a little battered now.
Superstar setting up.
Go, Slender! This could do it! And Batista pumps the shoulder up!
Right now, I just don't know what it's going to take.
Ooh, avoided the attack with an nasty chop block.
Yeah, the sense that fatigue is starting to become a factor at this point.
Make no illusions of it. This is coming down to a battle of attrition.
I am in shock. What's it going to take to keep this guy down?
Caught in a bad position here.
Here is your winner, the